Last week, we talked about a study showing that parents were willing to spend on toys that might give their kids a head start on teaching them lessons in STEM. That's science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. You don't have to spend a lot of money to give your kids some lessons that incorporate STEM.
Joining us now with four fun STEM-based ideas, we have Katie Kearns of Creative Kidstuff. Good morning.
Good morning.
This is fun because not only are we playing with toys, we are getting in a little bit of the learning, too.
Got to sneak Absolutely. It in. It's still got to be fun for the
yes.
kids, right?
Yes.
All right, so you have four ideas. The first one is family science night, right?
Yeah, well, I think part of it is that when you talk about STEM enrichment at home, it can be kind of intimidating, but it doesn't all have to be astrophysics and molecular biology. Yeah. It can actually be pretty simple. So over here, we have some ideas for a fun family science night. You could pick up a kit. You can also do things with what you have in your house already. One option is growing crystals. You can build a little form with pipe cleaners, put that in a jar with some water and borax, and then overnight, crystals are gonna form around that pipe cleaner.
Oh, cool.
Really fun. And there are a ton of great options for things, kitchen science type
sure.
experiments that you can do with things you already have in your house.
Awesome.
A lot of people have borax already, just kind of the laundry soap in
Absolutely.
Their home, so there you go. All right, your second idea is more into the tech. This is probably the hottest trend we're seeing in toys,
yes,
right?
Yes, absolutely. Kids are getting more and more tech savvy. There are new toys, all kinds of newfangled contraptions out there. And
so
sometimes
what is this?
It's hard for mom and dad to keep up. This is Spark from a company called Sphero. And this teaches kids to code. It's basic coding, and you can program this little guy. He's kind of like a little remote control robot.
Oh.
So you can program him, code him to do all kinds of little things, and then set him in motion, and he will just cruise all over your house.
So this is awesome. We have a Sphero at home,
yeah.
but this one actually lets you code it.
Yes.
Very cool.
What age group would that be for? It seems like, I mean, coding sounds so daunting to an adult, but a lot of kids
yeah.
are picking it up young.
You know, I think they recommend 8 and up on this one.
Okay.
I feel like you can kind of ease kids in a little bit younger than that, because it also has a free play option where it's more of just like a remote control vehicle.
Let's do some engineering.
Yes, next up, we love Yoxo for engineering. Engineering can be simple. It can be making a pulley system to get something up onto the top level of a double-decker bed,
sure.
or any kinds of best building practices.
You can make a lever, you can make all sorts of different stuff.
Absolutely. So this is really fun. We've got the Yoxo kits. They're all recycled materials, and they all have parts that fit together like this. So you can build any number of things,
oh, cool.
Whether it's using a kit or just free building. Contraptions galore.
I think I see a little geometry over here, so
yeah.
we're having some fun with math as your last tip.
Absolutely. Math is often the least favorite of the STEM, but we can still have a lot of fun with it. So you can do something easy, use some popsicle sticks and practice geometry. Even something like Lego bricks. Use Lego bricks and work on fractions with your kids. That
huh.
can be a really
oh.
hard thing, but there's ways to make this really fun and easy to do at home.
Very cool. All this is simple. A lot of people have this
yeah.
stuff at home already,
mm-hmm.
and of course you can pick it up at Creative Kids Stuff too.
Yes.
Kate, thanks so much. We appreciate it.
Thanks.
Thank you.